Hey guys, DMic here for another episode of Pokémon Brilliant Diamond. We are getting to the end of this brilliant game. And we are just about ready to take on the Elite Four. But first, Jasmine, talk to her again. She's very familiar with Sunny Shore, reminds her of Olivine City. There was also the lighthouse. If you remember, we helped out her sick aunt. Well, I mean, we didn't. Someone helped out her sick Ampharos. So now that we have the Sunny Shore Gym, our final collectible, we get Waterfall.
Waterfall, I'm an man.
So we'll need that in order to climb the actual waterfall that separates us from the Elite Four. I don't know. Are there trainers out here? Okay. So just a heads up, everybody. This episode is probably going to be on the longer side. I know I always say that, but I'm just going to combine everything here up until the Elite Four in this episode, just to make things tidy. So you'll have to forgive me if you don't like long episodes. This one's going to be a bit of a doozy. I'll try to keep it manageable and fun and light and amazing, like I always do. But yeah, this is the home stretch, everybody. We're doing it. And as you'll see in a moment, because I'm about to switch Pokemon, this is the final team. So we're going to go with Suzanne, Steven, Bart, Samuel, Miguel, and Charlie. Now, obviously, Suzanne is not fully evolved yet, but fear not. That will be changing soon. And you might notice that my Pokemon are a little bit higher level than they were previously. So I didn't know this, but I actually missed a couple routes when I was exploring. If you head left from Pastoria City, there is a Route 212, which has a bunch of kind of swampy marshlands. I missed about 2 to 3 sections of that and a few trainers. So I went back and I fought them. Wasn't really worth putting into a video because the trainers were 10 to 15 levels lower than me. So I got basically no experience. But there is a cool place that I should have shown off that I didn't, called the Fuego Ironworks. That's just above Floroma Town. If you head there, you can get yourself a TM for Flamethrower if you don't want to buy one from Veilstone, so that's fun. And just some other fire-related items, a Firestone, and I think that's it. So it's got a weird little warp puzzle in it, or like a sliding panel puzzle, whatever you want to call it. So if you're into that, go there, enjoy that, help yourself. Didn't really seem like something I cared much about. Also, you might be wondering, why is Suzanne holding an amulet coin? Well, I'll tell you. Amulet coin is an item we got earlier in the game, and it doubles the reward you get from the battle. So in this case, money! And I spent all my money trying to improve the team with TMs and vitamins. I made everybody a little bit faster by buying a bunch of Carbos. And Carbos are kind of expensive. It's about 10,000 Pokédollars per, which is a lot. So, also apparently Azurill is no longer weak to electric moves. I didn't know that. Oh, we have Azumarill though, which is good. So yeah, every time that we fight, I'm gonna start the battle with Suzanne because I want to get that extra cash since I used up all my money. So hopefully we'll be able to replenish quite a bit of it. There are quite a few trainers in the Victory Road, which we'll be taking on shortly. So that's pretty exciting. Also, get some final levels. The Thunder Wave's not bad. Let's see, is that worth getting rid of? I don't really foresee myself using Charge. I mean, it is... That's tough. I also don't really see myself using Strength. I did put Strength on Steven. The problem with Steven is that the best moves that Steven gets are not for a while. Like, it gets some really great moves in like the late 50s, early 60s, and I just don't know if I have the time or the patience for that. Strength is good though. Thunderbolt is the best electric move. It gets a better one eventually, but not for like a dozen levels, and I don't have time for that. I don't really know if I want a two-turn something. I mean, yeah, let's go ahead and go with Thunder Wave. Thunder Wave is nice, being able to paralyze your opponent, slow them down, and improve things in your favor. So yeah, I boosted some stats with everybody. I improved the moves. That's what I did as well. I tried to swap out, and I know some people will probably be watching this and be like, those aren't the best moves, and you know, you're right. They're probably not the best overall moves, but they're the best moves for what I was working with. So I also didn't realize there was gonna be so many water trainers. Okay. Guys, we'll make it. We're fine. Just don't panic. Don't panic. It's okay. We're gonna take everything a step at a time. We're gonna get so much cash from this. Just think about that. If you're worried about how things are gonna go, just think about how much cash money we're gonna wind up with at the end of this. I don't really need a ton, realistically speaking. I didn't know it knew this. Ouch. That's okay. We have a way to heal ourselves. But yes, I also taught Toxic and Leech Seed because I'm a turd burglar, and I love to do that. It is one of my favorite Mantyke's not just water, I forgot. It's one of my favorite combos to do, and the reason why I think it's important is because some of the Pokemon that are in the Elite Four, I don't really have answers for, if my memory serves me right, so I have to kind of cheese it a little bit. Some people might think it's cheap. I'm not going to do it a lot, but I mean, turning the tide of battle, sometimes throwing that leech seed out there can go a long way. So, you know, why not? It always helps. Remoraid. I could go for a nice glass of Remoraid. But yeah, I'm just trying to prepare myself in the best way. I'm going to be underleveled. That's already a fact going into this. I think the lowest Elite Four member starts at 53 or 55, one of those two. So they're pretty high up there, which is actually nice. It should create a bit of a challenge in this game where some of the other Elite Fours, they weren't super challenging. What comes to mind immediately is the Elite Four from Gold and Silver. Like, it's not that it wasn't challenging in the sense of like their Pokemon, but in general, the levels were really low. The levels in that game entirely were low, and that was just a bit of a bummer. So I'm going to use this opportunity for Victory Road to train the Pokemon that I have. We might be able to get up into the low 50s, which would be nice. And in doing so, it'll make us a little bit more competitive. But in general, I'm not super worried about it. I've been underleveled for most of this game, so that's what happens when you don't grind. Ain't grinding. Being safe. So I haven't fought any Pokemon once again, except for the ones that I've caught and accidentally fought. But I haven't gone out of my way to fight anybody besides just the trainers in this game. And I don't know if I fought every trainer in this game, but I feel like I fought most of them. So also, this is a lot. I did not know this was gonna, I might have to split Victor Road into two parts because this episode, I don't want it to be an hour. I didn't realize I was gonna be fighting all of these people. I mean, I'm fine with it, but you know, I got places to be, things to do. I'm a busy man. And double battles are not a way to speed up an episode. I don't wanna cut out any content, because I want you guys to see all of it. Uncut, raw, live. All right, that's enough. But yeah, so I went back and I retaught Beat Up to Suzanne. It's a cool move. It's not effective against Meryl, obviously, because Meryl is part fairy type, but which I think is the strangest thing. But Beat Up is probably the best dark move that Suzanne knows. I don't know if there's better options for Weavile, but for Sneasel, that's the best one you're gonna get. And it's a 60 base power move that with Stab is 90, plus it incorporates it doesn't have a base power, but when you do the math, according to my calculations, I think that it turns into being about roughly 60 base power. So that's nice, and you know, it's relatively effective for what you're trying to do. It's not the best move, I'm not gonna pretend like it is, but it'll get you there. There aren't really a ton of physical dark moves via TM or level up that you're gonna get for a Sneasel. which is a little frustrating, but, you know, you take what you get. I could go back and, like, breed egg moves and all that stuff, but, you know, I feel like that's not really in the spirit of what I'm trying to do. My goal here is to use the team in its kind of natural habitat. I mean, I almost went so far as to replace Steven, because Steven is a good Pokemon. Luxray in general is a good Pokemon. However, what I'm actually interested in was the fact that a Luxray can't learn a ton of physical electric moves. There just aren't that many. So it does put me in a bit of a bind, and I was considering going and catching a Magnemite, getting a Magneton, which would turn into a Magnezone, the final evolution of Magneton that was introduced in this game, which is very interesting. But I did not do that, in fairness to Steven. I wanted to keep the team that's been here from most of the beginning. You know, there have been some that have kind of crept in as time has gone on. So, you know, the team isn't 100% OG, but, you know, Suzanne, Samuel, Miguel, they're a little bit of like the second half of the game. We added them in, which is fine. It's fine. I said it was fine, therefore it's fine. I have to live with it. And I was also considering going and getting an Elkid, or Elekid, however you say it, which would be an Electabuzz, and then evolving an Electabuzz into an Electivire. Now, the problem with that idea is going out and getting an Electivire is tough. So you have to catch an Elekid, which you can only get in the underground first. So you have to catch an Elekid. An Elekid has a 5% chance of holding the evolution item that you need to get an Electivire. Then you have to find someone to trade with? Like, friends? What are those? Trade them your Electabuzz with the Electrizer item, and then trade them back to you. So, there you go. It's a whole lot of work, and I don't care that much about it, so... Sorry, guys. If you're hoping to see an Electivire, you will not in this Let's Play. There's an item over there. You're traveling, but you're all wet. You're swimming. So yeah, thankfully some of these trainers only have one Pokemon. Well, that was a neat little animation. So here's a Tentacruel. Tentacruel is great. I haven't really talked a ton about Tentacruel, and I always thought it was just kind of a whatever Pokemon, but it turns out that Tentacruel is actually pretty good. And I'm not entirely sure how this works, digging underwater, but I had low sweep on Suzanne, but it wasn't really the best move. And in fairness, there wasn't really the move set for Sneasel's not great. I mean, there isn't even really a physical ice move. So, you know, you just take what you get. I mean, the best ice move physically, I think, that you can get is like Ice Punch for Sneasel, but you have to breed it onto it. Also, once again, not trying to do that. Man, some of these earnings are a little paltry here, everybody. Cough it up. How do I get over there? I want that item. How do I get to you? Okay. Listen how whimsical this music is. I also went back and bought more Super Repels, because it's gonna be a bit of a doozy. There's a lot of wild Pokemon in Victory Road. Can I do anything with this? Nope. Well, that item will be lost to time, because I don't think I'm ever gonna come back. Never coming back. Okay. We're almost at the 15-minute mark, and I'm still fighting trainers. I haven't even touched Victory Road. Yeah, we'll probably have to split it up. We'll do halfsies, I'm assuming. Do a little bit of suspense for the Elite Four, and I'm trying to figure out how I want to do that. There's an Elite Four, obviously. 1, 2, 3, 4 battles in a row. No healing in between. Without your items, you can't go to a Pokemon Center or anything like that. But don't worry, I got plenty of Malk, so my Pokemon are fine. And then there's a Champion. So, and we've actually already met one of the Elite Four members. For whatever reason, they just kind of shoehorn Flint into the beginning of Sunny Shore. It doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. I can't explain why they thought it was a good idea, but they're like, hey, you know what would be cool? Let's put one of the members of the Elite Four in there for no reason, and it means nothing. That's basically what they did, so. But I went ahead and gave Samuel Earthquake. He doesn't learn it naturally, so I taught it the old TM. You only get one of those, and since this is my final team, it seemed like a good idea to teach a thick boy like Samuel a great move, like Earthquake. It is arguably the best of the ground moves, so why not? I don't remember what we had before. Earth Power or something like that. I also got rid of Ancient Power. Speaking of power. I thought that Rock Slide was a bit of a better move. It's stronger. It doesn't hit as hard. It doesn't hit as accurately. It does hit as hard. It hits harder, actually. So there's that. You found a trainer floating in the water, and I'm full of fee! So, yeah, I boosted the moves a little bit. Yeah, this is really uninspiring. Having to fight a bunch of water trainers before you go to the Elite Four. This is real annoying. And it's extra annoying because I'm switching in between all of my Pokemon to get them some experience. Having Suzanne out there first is intentional, obviously, for the amulet coin. Minute for the coin, for the cash. But in general, this is not my favorite. So I didn't really need to do this, but I taught Miguel Fly. I don't really know if there's a better... That was a weird animation. I don't know if I have a better physical move for Miguel. Miguel's more of a physical attacker. So I have a really good dark move. I decided to stay with Nightshade, although unless you're overleveled, Nightshade's kind of uninspiring. Because if you remember the mechanics of it, it doesn't do damage based on a power. It does damage based on the level your Pokemon is. So right now, the most damage that Miguel could do is 47, and it's not powered by anything. So it's a ghost move with how it's like labeled in the game, but it's not going to be effective as a ghost move, which is kind of a bummer, but you know, it's whatevs. We're going to make the best of it. It's fine, guys. It's fine. Don't worry about it. I got your back. Like Chiroprac. Okay. Gotta go worship my crystals after these battles. Recharge my aura. Okay. Hopefully. Okay, we fought you. Please just... oh my gosh, please. No more. Are you... No. I mean, I was actually kind of dreading that I wasn't going to be fighting enough trainers in Victory Road to level up, but I did not need the prequel here, the wet prequel. Feeling pretty moist right now, and I don't like it. All right. I am excited, though. I will tell you in advance. We will have a fully evolved team by the time Victory Road has completed, so you got something to look forward to. That's for sure. I don't know if I'm going to go for a time limit or a distance limit on this episode, but I'm not really familiar with the Elite. Nope. With the Victory Road of this generation, so I'm just going to have to wing it. Okay. Oh, do you remember when we had a stockpile on Brandy? That was fun. And I realized Brandy was useless. Yeah. So the team that I'm going to be going to the Elite Four with, obviously, is the one that I have, the six present, but I might roll through the post game. There's some things that I can do there. I might roll through the post game with some of the other people that you won't see, just to mix it up a little bit. And I also realized that there are some really neat things you can do in this game if you complete Pokemon Legends Arceus. So that might have to be a thing where, because I'm not super far into that game, we might have to, pump the brakes on this one, and then, you know, I might start a new series and then come back to this later on once I finish Arceus. Because you have to 100% that game in order to get some of the things in this one, which I think is kind of a nice coupling that they made. They obviously had that in mind, but there are some unique things that you can do in this game only if you beat Arceus. So I like to show off as much as I can, in the post game, but I can only do that once I've completed the game. So I haven't done that yet. I'm about, I don't know, I'd say like 60, 70%. Oh, I didn't know you could use that while I'm flying. That's rude. Don't punch me while I'm flying. Some birds are worth punching though. You ever been somewhere and like there have been geese, Canada geese? Those things are so rude and they're scary. I remember when I was younger, I was taking a gym class and one of our it looks like he's wearing sweatpants. One of our required activities, I love sweatpants, by the way, was to go fishing for the day. We were going to go fishing at the local watering hole. Ooh, a pearl. But for diamonds, as you can obviously tell, I don't need that yet. I should have agreed to it, but I didn't want to waste the 10 steps. And now I can waste another repel. Great. Actually, I don't know if I'm going to have enough for all of Victory Road. I didn't realize there was going to be... Oh, poo. I didn't... That's walkable terrain. All right, are you the last one? No. This episode might literally just be these fights. That makes me a very sad panda. And these fights aren't bad. Like, you're getting to see some decent leveled Pokemon and evolutions and stuff. Oh, man, it is boring. But anyway, back to fishing. So I went fishing with my class as part of our required credit hour or whatever, and didn't really know much about it. Still don't. Fishing's okay. It's probably not a top five activity for me, but I can understand why people like it. To each their own. So went fishing, and we had to bring a lunch. So I did, and my lunch was, I don't know, something basic, but I remember one of the things I had in said lunch was Pringles. Can we get a shout out for Pringles? Please don't sue me, whoever makes Pringles. All right, first level 50 is Steven. Yeah, we're getting up there. Maybe we won't be too far off by the time we finish up. No, you are plenty fast, Suzanne, you don't need that. I think Suzanne's actually, let's check real quick. Just for curiosity, I want to say that Suzanne actually might be the fastest on the team. Maybe. What's awesome is that two of my Pokemon have a speed down nature. Isn't that great? Don't you love that? Actually, to go and jump them full of vitamins just to get them up to speed. You know what I'm saying? So, had Pringles in my lunch. And I was very excited to eat them until, out of the blue, there's a harem of geese. I don't know, flock? Is there a specific word for geese? I know that there are certain types of animals that have really, really cool names for their collections, like a parliament of owls, a crash of rhinos, a murder of crows. So. I don't know if there's anything like that for geese, but you could just call them a bunch of jerks. So that was terrifying, and they were harassing me for my Pringles, and I didn't want to share my Pringles because they were my Pringles that I bought with my lawn mowing money or whatever. I don't live life. I don't work endlessly at my job to subsidize Pringles for geese. I don't. So I told them to bump off, and they did not. And they're very aggressive, and they also bite really, really hard. So you gotta be careful with that. You don't want to mess with them. But here's Rock Slide getting its first debut. Thought that would have done more. Did not. Oops. But Rock Slide's a great move. Causes flinching, which is awesome. I mean, I also taught Samuel Ice Beam. So I'm just trying to get some coverage. Samuel's kind of my utility guy. He's what I go to when I don't really know what to do. It's got good defenses. Its offenses aren't bad. And it can learn a lot of stuff. So a ground water type is a great typing. I think it's probably why everybody loved Mudkip and Ruby and Sapphire, because it was just such a good type. I mean, firefighting is great. That's why they made every starter since the beginning of time firefighting, right? Why is this here? Is there a hidden thing? Or is this just me wasting a repel? Oh yeah, that's what that was. The game got me good. I have been officially bamboozled. All right, I think we're almost done. Bear with me, everybody. I almost kind of feel bad if I'm going to jump into Victory Road after this. It would feel a little disjointed. We might just have a little bit of build up to Victory Road, and then we can come back at it. Haha, you thought, sucker. All right, so, I mean, Miguel can handle this. It's not really a good type advantage, but whatever, that's not fun. I'm also trying to just balance it out. Make sure everybody on the team is relatively well leveled. Hopefully, maybe in the low 50s by the end of Victory Road. I'm assuming that the experience all will allow that to happen. Okay, so this Gyarados apparently loves to waste time. Man, I wish I had a Gyarados on my team now. Gyarados is so cool. I can wax poetic about Gyarados forever. I just love it so much. It's definitely a top 5 Pokemon for me. And its Mega Evolution is cool because it gets a Dragon typing, which I think is great. Yes. I wish I had a better flying move than Brave Bird. What I did learn is that right after I caught Miguel, I was asked to acquire Murkrow for someone else, and in doing so, I learned that Murkrow had Drill Peck, which would have been awesome. Okay, everybody, are you ready? This is Pokemon League, but this is not... We're not there yet. And you're not technically there even after you finish this, because you have to go through Victory Road. But they do give you Pokemon Center. Yeah. Let's heal up one last time. I'll listen to this music. That's fun. I also haven't been talking to NPCs in Pokemon Centers. I don't know if that matters. Oops. My bad. Yeah, if I do the Victory Road, it would feel a little strange, so I might just call it here. Okay. It broke you. Uh-oh. Did it break your back mountain? I don't know. But yeah. Next time, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be taking on Victory Road. So thanks for watching this watery slog. I've been DMic. This has been Pokemon Brilliant Diamond, and I'll see you next time. Bye.